I think there are two major challenges which we face. One is climate change, and the other one is sustainability. And so for climate change, it's happening already. In view of sustainability, the European Union has set up very important strategies, the farm to fork and the biodiversity strategy, which should help getting European agriculture more sustainable. In this context, there are a number of reduction targets for pesticides, for example, also for fertilizers. And in principle, all these targets will have an effect on productivity, which means maybe around more than 20% productivity loss in crop production. And that's, of course, a lot. And having in mind that already today, plant breeding contributes 2/3 to productivity growth, genetic improvement in view of plant breeding gets even more important. And having in mind that these strategies are supposed to be implemented by 2030, we need to speed up to be able to contribute. And this is why we need new innovative tools in breeding to help addressing those productivity challenges in view of the goals I just mentioned, but also when you look at climate change, for example, drought tolerant plants or pest and disease resistant plants. Also, this is, of course, ongoing and on the, let's say, in the focus of plant breeders already today. When you look at, let's say, the sustainability challenges we have, but also the challenges from climate change, there are, on the one hand, new biotic stresses, which means new pests and diseases coming up due to climate change, but also, of course, drought and sometimes even flooding. But then, of course, we want to have healthy diets. We want to produce more sustainable. And plant breeding can actually contribute to all these different goals, for example, by providing new plant varieties which have a better disease resistance against new pests and diseases. So you can save plant protection products, or you have new plant varieties with a better quality or better composition of vitamins, oils, etc. That helps, of course, to address health issues. But then also when it comes to, for example, processing of plants during the production process of food, also here, better processability could, for example, help saving energies, etc. So all these, let's say, contributions plant breeding can make realize sometimes on the farmer's field already, but also they can also realize further down the value chain when it comes to processing, but also when it comes to the consumer, for example, vegetable varieties with a better shelf life to avoid food waste. So plant breeding can really play a role in all these different aspects. It's not the silver bullet, but it's one important contributor. Indeed, we are discussing the topic on the new breeding techniques already in Europe since more than a decade. But with the European Court of Justice ruling in 2018, which put all those new technologies under the current GMO framework, the discussion became more, let's say, intense, because many actors and stakeholders realized that that will put Europe probably in a competitive disadvantage compared to other parts of the world where already new regulations and guidelines have been implemented, which regulate those products in a much more differentiated manner. And that's actually also where we would like the European Union see to take a more differentiated approach, not only looking at the technology that has been used to create a new plant variety, but also at the outcome. So meaning the genetics changes that have been introduced, the phenotype, and to compare it with what can also be achieved by conventional breeding or even by processes in nature and then regulate respectively. So meaning if a product is more conventional-like, it should be regulated as a conventional plant variety. If it's more GMO-like, classical GMO-like, it should be regulated as a GMO. So, and that's the approach taken in many other parts of the world, and in order to make Europe competitive on the one hand, but also in line in view of trade, seed trade, commodity trade, but also germplasm exchange for breeding, for research, that would be, from our perspective, the way forward.